Today, let me explain about polygenic traits and quantitative inheritance. Now, this also becomes an example for deviation from Mendel's principles. All the traits are characters studied by Mendel have two alternative forms without any intermediate forms in between. Such traits, for example, in garden peas, the seed shape is either round or wrinkled. There is no shape of the seed in between. Similarly, the height of the plant, it is either tall or dwarf. Such traits are characters having two alternative forms without any intermediate or graded forms are called qualitative traits or characters. So, what are qualitative traits? What are qualitative characters? The traits are the characters which have two alternative forms, two alternative expressions without the intermediate forms in between are called qualitative traits. All the characters studied by Mendel in the garden pea plant, they are all of this type, qualitative traits. Now, such qualitative traits are controlled by a single gene pair. All such qualitative traits are controlled by a single gene pair. Hence, these qualitative traits are also called monogenic traits. The qualitative traits, hence, are also called monogenic traits or monogenic characters. There are, however, several traits which show a continuous gradation between two extremes. There are, however, several traits which show a continuous gradation, a continuous variation between two extremes. For example, in human skin color, show gradation from black to white with intermediate shades. Similarly, height in a human, it varies from tall to short, with graded forms. So, in human, the skin color, height of the body, they are of this type. These are called quantitative traits. Unlike the former qualitative traits, where there is no gradation, there are only two alternative expressions without intermediate forms. But in several traits, such as in human, skin color and height, they show a continuous gradation from one extreme to another. So as far as skin color is concerned, it shows a continuous gradation from black to white, and height in human, it shows a continuous variation from tall to short. Now such type of traits, characters, are called quantitative traits. Now they are called quantitative traits because these traits, they are measured in, they are measured in terms of quantity, and hence they are called quantitative traits. Now these quantitative traits, they are controlled both by heredity and environment. In other words, both heredity and environment contributes for the expression of these quantitative traits. Now such quantitative traits are controlled by the additive effects of two or more pairs of non-allelic genes called polygenes. These quantitative traits are controlled by the additive effects of two or more pairs of non-allelic genes called polygenes. Now the inheritance of characters controlled by these polygenes, they control the expression of quantitative traits. And hence, the traits controlled by these polygenes are called polygenic traits, and the inheritance is called polygenic inheritance or quantitative inheritance. So these quantitative traits, they are controlled by the additive effects of two or more pairs of non-allelic genes called polygenes and the traits controlled by these polygenes, that is quantitative traits controlled by the polygenes, the quantitative traits are also called polygenic traits, and the inheritance is called a polygenic inheritance or quantitative inheritance. Now these polygenes, particularly the dominant form of these polygenes, their effects are additive, their effects are cumulative in the expression of the phenotype. Now, more the number of dominant polygenes, more will be the phenotype prominent. The phenotype becomes more and more prominent depending on more the number of dominant polygenes. So the effect of the dominant form of polygenes becomes additive or cumulative, and as a result each dominant polygene contributes certain amount of the phenotype, and the effect of these dominant polygenes becomes additive or cumulative, and more the number of dominant polygenes, more will be the prominent form of the character. The phenotype becomes more prominent, and hence these polygenes are also often called cumulative genes. So there are several names for these polygenes. So polygenes are also called cumulative genes. Sometimes they are also called multiple genes. Multiple genes. So polygenes are also called multiple genes or cumulative genes. So here multiple genes, the other name for polygenes, it should not be confused with multiple alleles. These are little bit confusing. So multiple alleles and multiple genes are different. Multiple allele refers to the different forms of the same gene when the number of alleles is more than two. So when a given gene takes more than two allelic forms, all those forms of the same gene, they are called multiple alleles. But here multiple gene means polygenes. So multiple genes are polygenes which are two or more pairs of non-allelic genes controlling a phenotype or a trait. Now we shall illustrate the polygenic trait and the inheritance with an illustration or with an example. The best example to illustrate polygenic trait and polygenic inheritance is inheritance of skin color in a human. Inheritance of skin color in human is a best example to explain polygenes and polygenic inheritance or quantitative inheritance. The inheritance of skin color in human, it was first studied by C.B. Davenport. The inheritance of skin color in human, it was first studied by C.B. Davenport in the year 1933. Now, the inheritance of skin color in human, it is believed to be controlled by at least three pairs of polygenes. Skin color in human is controlled by at least three different pairs of polygenes. Now, skin color in human, grades from black to white, in between there are intermediate graded shades. Now, black color in human, it is due to these three pairs of genes. All are dominant. Now, each dominant polygene affects certain amount of blackness, and when all these six dominant genes here, whose effect becomes additive or cumulative, results in pure black color of the skin. Similarly, the white skin color, it is due to the three pairs of genes in their recessive form. So, black individuals will have this genotype, and white individuals will have this genotype. Now, when two such persons, one being a black and another being white, when they marry, what type of children they produce? And the individuals with the genotype found in the F1 or in the children, when they marry, what will be the type of the children they produce in the next generation? We shall just have the details about such marriages. So one is a black individual, these are the three pairs of polygenes responsible for black skin color. Married to a white individual, this is the genotype. Now, they produce the children, that is F1 generation. skin color of the children, skin color of the F1 progeny, it is not completely black or completely white, but it is intermediate between these two. So that is, the individuals will have the intermediate skin color, that is brown. Now here, these individuals will have heterozygous genotype, capital A, small a, capital B, small b, capital C, small c. Now the children produced here, the F1 progeny here, will have only three dominant polygenes, and hence the cumulative effect of these three dominant polygenes, this will be half of the effect that is produced here. So therefore, the F1 progeny will have the skin color between black and white, that is brown. Now such children born here with the brown skin color, they are called mulatto. So mulatto, these are the individuals having brown skin color produced by a marriage between two individuals, one being black, another being white. Now when two mulattoes, when two mulattoes marry, how is the progeny produced in the next generation, that is F2 generation? Now each of the mulatto will have this heterozygous genotype. Now each mulatto produce gametes. Now the gamete produced by each mulatto will have 8 different allelic combination, genic combination. Now there is a simple method to estimate, to find out the number of gamete produced. Now when there is one pair of genes, a heterozygous individual will produce how many types of gametes? That is given as 2 to the power 1, that is 2 different types of gametes. Now this can be very clearly seen when you examine the monohybrid cross of Mendel. So in a monohybrid cross of Mendel, the F1 individual will be heterozygous, for example capital T small t, and individual with the genotype capital T small t, when they produce gamete, they produce 2 different types of gametes. So the number of gamete produced there, when there is one pair of genes, 2 gametes. When there are 2 pairs of genes, heterozygous individual or F1 individual produce how many types of gametes? That will be given as 2 to the power 2. That is 2 into 2, 4. So 4 different types of gametes are being produced by a dihybrid individual. If there are 3 pairs, if there are 3 pairs of 3 pairs of genes. Now here, we have 3 pairs of genes in a heterozygous individual or F1 individual. Such individual will produce how many types of gametes? Now here this will be given as 2 to the power 3. That is 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2, 8. So 8 different types of gametes are going to be produced. So one mulatto will produce 8 different types of gametes. The other mulatto here will produce 8 different types of gametes. Now when these 8 different types of gametes of one parent, when they are randomly fertilized by similar 8 different types of gamete produced by other mulatto, the children produced in the F2 progeny show 64 different genotypic combinations appearing in 7 different phenotypes, and these 7 different phenotypes of the skin color, they range between black and white. So here in the F2 generation, 64 genotypic combinations showing 7 different phenotypes, and 7 different types of phenotypes in their proportion is been given below. Now 1 out of 64 will have black skin color, very much like the black individual. Six out of 64 will have the skin color little less than pure black, complete black. That is, 6 out of 64 will have very dark brown. 6 out of 64 will be very dark brown. 15 out of 64 will be dark brown. Twenty out of 64 will be brown. That is between black and white. Why a media between black and white? That is, 20 out of 64 will be mulatto, just like this. And 15 out of 64. So here the graph will move. It will go to the peak and then again come down. So here after brown, again 15 out of 64 will be light brown. Six out of 64 very light brown. Intensity will be still less, blackness. And last one, 1 out of 64 will be white. So these are 7 different phenotypes with 16 genotypic combinations will appear in the F2 progeny. Now here, the pattern of inheritance of skin color in human, it is a quantitative trait or a polygenic trait, because here the skin color does not appear in only 2 alternative forms. Skin color in human does not appear only in 2 forms, black and white. But on the contrary, on the other hand, the skin color in human It varies from black to white. The skin color in human, it shows a continuous gradation, a continuous variation between two extremes, that is black and white. So such a trait or such a character which shows a continuous gradation between two extremes is called a polygenic trait or a quantitative trait. Now this is being controlled by two or more pairs of non-allelic genes called polygenes. So to illustrate this polygenic trait and polygenic inheritance or quantitative inheritance, a best example here is inheritance of skin color in human. So each dominant polygene will contribute a certain unit of phenotype. So more the number of dominant genes, more will be the intensity of the trait. In other words, quantitative traits do not show a clear-cut difference in individuals with regard to the trait, but there is a spectrum of phenotypes which blend gradually from one type to another type, causing a continuous variation. So here, the skin color in human, it varies from grades from black to white, but you don't have a clear-cut difference. But here the phenotype shows a spectrum, and in this spectrum of the phenotype, that is a skin color, one type continues with the other type, resulting in a continuous gradation of the character. So the skin color in human shows a continuous gradation from black to white, and hence the inheritance of skin color in human is a best example for quantitative trait or polygenic trait, and the inheritance is called polygenic inheritance or polygenic quantitative inheritance. Now next about pleiotropy. Some genes regulate many phenotypic traits simultaneously. Some genes regulate many phenotypic traits simultaneously. So such a gene with multiple phenotypic effects is called pleiotropic gene. Pleiotropic gene. What do you mean by pleiotropic gene? A gene with multiple phenotypic effects. This is called a pleiotropic gene. Now the ability of this gene with multiple phenotypic effects is called a pleiotropy. So what is pleiotropy and what is a pleiotropic gene? the gene with multiple phenotypic effects is called a pleiotropic gene, and the ability of the gene with multiple phenotypic effects is called pleiotropy. Now, this can be illustrated with a few examples. One, in garden peas, gene controlling flower color, gene controlling the flower color also responsible for seed coat color as well as the presence of red spots in the leaf axil. So here there is a single gene, and this single gene controls multiple phenotypic effects simultaneously. So here it is not one gene, one character, but here gene is one and expressions are many, multiple phenotypic effects caused by a single gene. So in garden peas, one gene that controls flower color also controls seed coat color as well as the presence of red spots in the leaf axil. Similarly, in Drosophila, commonly called fruit fly, there is a mutant gene. A gene that has undergone mutation, a mutant gene. Now this mutant gene, it is responsible for white eye color. See, the normal eye color in Drosophila, the wild type of eye color in Drosophila is a red eye color. Now the gene that is responsible for red eye color, when it mutates, it takes a new form, that is mutant form of this gene, and this mutant form of this gene is responsible for another type of eye color, that is white eye color. So instead of red eye color, now the eye color will be white-eyed due to this mutant gene. Now this mutant gene, which is responsible for white eye color, but the same is again responsible for depigmentation. This is responsible for depigmentation, means loss of pigment in other parts of the body. Not only the eye loses the red color, so many body parts of this fly, Drosophila, also lose the pigmentation. So here, gene is one, but the effects are multiple. So such gene, this gene in the case of garden pea and this gene in the case of Drosophila, gene happened to be single, but the effects are many. So such type of gene is called pleiotropic gene, and the ability of this gene with multiple phenotypic effects is called pleiotropy. If you just examine closely, the pleiotropy is exactly converse to polygenic inheritance. So in the case of polygenic inheritance, character is single, but the controlling factor genes are many. So many genes controlling a single character, that is polygenic inheritance. But converse to that, gene is one, but the controlling traits are many. So there, character is one controlled by many genes, but here, gene is one controlling many traits or characters. So that is pleiotropy. Now a famous example for pleiotropy, a famous example for pleiotropy in human. So in the case of human, a famous example to illustrate pleiotropy is a hereditary disease called sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia, this is a hereditary disease in human, and this inheritance of this disease, sickle cell anemia, this is also a famous example for pleiotropy. And what is this disease, sickle cell anemia? More details we are going to study later in one of the chapters from genetics. So at that juncture, at that moment, we shall learn more about this hereditary disease called sickle cell anemia. But at this moment, you remember that the inheritance of this disease is also an example of pleiotropy.